Do I really need a recovery email? Yes, you do. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com, where I try to help give you a little bit more confidence and reduce your fear when it comes to technology. This is a question that I got just the other day that kind of struck me, and I'll tell you why in a moment. Okay, I'm confused. How does the recovery email on Google work? Where do I get the messages? Do we really need a recovery email? Now, the reason this struck me is because recovery emails, or alternate email addresses as they're sometimes called, are a concept that, honestly, I think a lot of people just take for granted. Certainly people in my position. It seems obvious to us what it is and why it is, and yes, why you so desperately need it. However, obviously, that's not an assumption I should be making. So let's walk through exactly what a recovery email is, why you need it, and I'll show you along the way how we set one up. So for the purposes of this video, I'm going to assume you have a Gmail account, since that's what the question came in as. Setting up a recovery email for your Gmail account starts by creating a second email account. A completely separate second email account. My recommendation is that you set it up on some other service. In other words, if you're setting up an alternate email account for your Gmail account, set up the alternate email account somewhere else. I'm going to use Outlook.com for our examples today. So, for example, I have two separate email accounts. I have my original account, askleotest@gmail.com. And then I have a second account that I'll be using as the recovery account. That's askleoexample@hotmail.com. Okay, let's set an alternative email account for my Gmail account. So here we are in Gmail. You can tell that this account gets very little mail. It's all spam, as it turns out. What we want to do is we want to go to your account in Gmail. So I'm clicking on the icon that is associated with this account. If you have a profile picture, that will show up here. Otherwise, it'll just be initials associated with your name. In this case, it's askleotest, and we're going to manage your Google account. We'll click on security on the left-hand side here. And then we will take a look at ways we can verify it's you. We want recovery email. Now, as you can see, I already have this set up. In going through the companion article for this video, I went through the steps and set this stuff up. But you can see here that what we've done is we have specified this other email address on this other service to be the recovery email address for this account. Now, if I set this, in other words, if I were to change it to something else, what will happen is Google will send an email to the recovery account. In other words, I will get a message at askleoexample@hotmail.com. And in fact, I can show you the message that I got when I set this up the other day. Here you can see the message that came from Google to my alternate email address, askleoexample@hotmail.com, saying that, hey, you requested using this as a recovery email for your Google account, askleotest@gmail. If that's what you want, enter this code. Then you would go back to this setup process of setting up the recovery email address and enter the code. And all would be done. And in fact, if we were to take a look at the rest of the recent security activity associated with this account, you can see here the recovery email was changed and verified. That's setting up a recovery email address. So, again, the important takeaway here is that we have our primary account, our Google account, askleotest@gmail.com, and we now have configured a recovery email address, askleoexample@hotmail.com, for this account. Great. What does that mean? When would you use it? How do you use it? Well, it turns out to be very similar to how you set it up in the first place. The scenario is this. For whatever reason, you can't sign into your Gmail account. Perhaps the password was forgotten, perhaps your account was hacked, perhaps there's something else going on. Nonetheless, you can't sign in. So we've gone to the sign-in screen and we've typed in the email address that we want to sign in as. We'll click Next and it'll ask for our password. Now, in this case, LastPass has remembered it for me, but let's assume that for whatever reason, that password didn't work, or I've literally forgotten the password. Then it's the forgot password path that one would take. You would click on that, and that would then begin a recovery process that would allow you to set a new password. Notice that get a verification code at this alternate email address is one of the options. If I select that, Gmail will send an email to that email address containing another 6-digit code. My ability to provide that 6-digit code correctly is what verifies me as being the rightful owner of this account. Because as the rightful owner of this account, when I was able to sign in, I set up this specific alternate email address. In effect, I was telling Gmail, this other address, it's me too. So if you ever need to verify that I am who I say I am, you can contact me at this other email address. And that's what this recovery process involves. Emailing another code to that alternate email address that I could then use to sign into my Gmail account. For an account recovery lost password scenario, it generally means then that you are going to create a new password for the Gmail account. Interestingly enough, we have two email accounts here. Honestly, there's nothing special about them, either of them. One is neither better nor worse than the other. It's all about how I use them. I happen to have designated Gmail as my primary email account, and I've set up the Outlook.com account as its alternate. But the fact is, they're just two email accounts. They both need alternates. Really, if there's ever a time when I can't access both of them, that's the only time that I really have a problem of being able to get in. So it's important that I be able to access the Outlook.com account as well. And one way to do that is to set up a recovery email address there as well. And yes, it is perfectly valid to have the first account have the second as its recovery and have the second account be the first as its recovery. Yes, there are some scenarios that doesn't cover. You can go down a rabbit hole here, right? You can have a whole linked list of email account after email account. The chances of both accounts being inaccessible at the same time, very low. All the other scenarios where one account would not be accessible, you generally have access to the other one in order to get the recovery code. Like I said, when I started, I definitely prefer having your recovery email address be some other service. You can, if you like, have another Gmail account be the recovery email address for your primary Gmail account. The only downside of that is that sometimes there are issues which will prevent you from signing into your primary account that will also prevent you from signing into your secondary account. A good example is travel. Sometimes services will throw additional verification steps in your way if you happen to be traveling. That could apply to both of these accounts. By having an account on different services, you'll then have different criteria and presumably different issues may or may not come up, but they won't come up at the same time. Chances are, while you're on the road, for example, if you can't get to your Gmail account, you can probably get to your Microsoft account and vice versa. Again, travel is just an example. There are other scenarios, but that is one of the reasons that I suggest having your alternate email address be on a different email service. Now, one last thing I want to talk about, and that is managing your alternate email account. One of the common, perhaps the most common ways I hear from people who end up losing access to their primary account forever is because they did in fact set up an alternate email account, and then they completely forgot about it. They never signed into it, they never maintained it, they never changed it, they never did anything with it. When they finally got around to needing it, it wasn't there anymore. For whatever reason, maybe lack of activity, any number of things, they did not have an account recovery email address that they could access anymore, and as a result, they were unable to prove that they were the rightful holder of their primary account. Don't let that be you. With respect to recovery information, maintain it. Make sure that you can access your recovery account. Make sure that, for example, if you have other recovery mechanisms in place, that they all apply. But when it comes to an alternate email address, I recommend, if you have no other reason to do so, log into that account once a month. Just make sure it's still there. Make sure you can still get messages there, just in case you ever really need it. I hope that helps clarify exactly what recovery emails are all about and why they're so critically important to your account's security. For updates, for related links, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/151482. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.